Together with our personal and communal intentions in this holy sacrifice of the Mass, let us also include in our prayers the intentions of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for all the intentions of all the devotees of the pilgrims of Basilica del Santo in Cebu, and for all the poor souls in purgatory. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Altogether, I confess
to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned
in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
with God. Grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him, and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him, and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, given you a title, though you know me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love, and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters, loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and the Holy Spirit, and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
How they might trap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man, and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this, and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." And that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you.
Lahit na nagatoo, nagasalig mo, Ginoo. Nagsalig mo. Weh. Ano, gagawin mo ito ba? Nagsalig mo, Ginoo. Tala, ito ba kita nagsalig sa Ginoo? Malipayan mo. Tala, that's the spirit. Malipayan mo, nagsalig sa Ginoo. Sa ato pala yung mga isuon, kung nagatong nagsalig mo sa Ginoo, nakaila mo sa Ginoo. Nakaila mo ni Kristo. Nakaila mo? Kinsa man si Kristo? Kana. Si Kristo ay soon sa inyong isa si Tribalo mo na kaitanong, isa si Kristo sa inyong kinabuhi. Amen. Tribalo niyo po na, my soul. Si Kristo, gitrik ba? Ngayon ba nakapit lang gihingon niya, the enemy of my enemy is my friend. Hindi mga Pharisees at hindi mga Herodians. Kontra ni sila, Pharisees, they believe and they only follow the law of Moses. And they hate so much this tax collection from the Rome. Hindi mga Herodians, they believe and they follow Rome, the severity of Rome. Mauna ang mga Herodians o kiling Pharisees, kontra yun sila. Pero kiling nga tayo sa atong Ebanghelyo, mga isoon, nagkasinagod silang duha. Kanyang paliyog sa usap niyo siya, kay murang mawala ko. Kining mga Herodians o kining mga Pariseo, kining mga Herodians o kining mga Pariseo, kontra ni sila. Pero kining at tayo nagkasinabot silang duha, na ilahang dikton kini si Kristo. Kay gusto man ni mga Pariseo na si Kristo kanyang makataga nila o sala. Siguro siguro ngayon na panahon, sa atong panahon, karon siguro na maminawon na ibitik si Kristo ni maumautana, angay ba magbayad ng tax? Pero at the time of Jesus, kini nga pangutana, it's a matter of life and death. No? Seryoso kayo nga pangutana, matter of life and death, yun is yun. Munang si Kristo, ibalukot kung saan magtubag, kung sa'y paagi. Si Kristo, kung nakabantay mo mga isoon sa style ni Kristo, kalmar dito siya nagtubag. Ay kahibalo siya kung sa'y nga matuburan, iyahangi. O interesting pa dito kayo, nagamit siya o koy, sinsiliyo, no? Gamit siya ang sinsiliyo para atagan o emphasis ang iyahang point na makaluwas both sa iyaha o sa mga nagasunod kaniya. Kaya masipyan kung tubag si Kristo mga isoon, and as a matter of fact, mga po na ilasok na nung si Kristo ilahang ipatay o ilansang sa krus na naman against the government. O maunin ka rin po ang ilahang kuha na tubag ng Kristo na makakuha silang tubag na against sa ni Caesar, ni Julius Caesar. Pumutubag si ang mga Herodians may nangutana ni ini, siyempre kauban ng mga Pariseo para lagi si Kristo himuan nila o sala. Mao nga si Kristo na nahibalo ngayon kung saan po pagtubag. Kuha siya ko eh, pagkahuman, simple na tayo inatubag. Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God, what belongs to God. Hindi di ba matulungan mga isong ihatag ng Caesar ang para sa iya ha, o ihatag sa Ginoo ang para sa Ginoo. Sa atong kinabuhi, kung ta, maka-identify kita kung unsa para sa Ginoo na atong mahatag sa Ginoo. Kung maka-identify kita kung unsa ang para ka dinhi sa ato sa kalibutan. Dili para sa Ginoo. Busa, kung ato na ma-identify, ato na mamalalungan sa atong kasing-kasing, kung sa'y kaya na itong i-give up, ihatag sa Ginoo, kanan para sa Ginoo, pinagsalig man na sa Ginoo, mitungo man na sa Ginoo, ato ganyan, kung ihatag ang para sa Ginoo. simple kaayo nga example kanang kanaganing manghatag ka sa ato ang kanang salibot sa ato ang sa atong simbahan. Simple kay nga example kaya nga atong ihatag ang taon ang sobra. Ang sobra kaya atong ihatag kuhayos ay di atong Jesus. No? Simple na kayo ng example. Then, muhanan ka nga nagsabi ka sa Ginoo. Then, muhanan ka nga nagatuo ka sa Ginoo. But, your action speaks differently. No? Simple na kayo may example. Pero, ang atong buhay, kung nagsabi ka sa Ginoo, mga isoon, kahibawag kita. Unsay buhaton o ihatag sa Ginoo kanato kung ato siya manahon. Kung ato siya manahon. Unahon gini mo ang Ginoo, unahon ko ba sa Ginoo. Pero kung imo lang gini siya second, third, sobra-sobra. Second, third, o sobra-sobra ka sa Ginoo. Hindi kayo mamalalungan ang gini punong karoon sa Ibanghilyo. Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God. Ato tanang madalas ato kasing-kasing mga isoon ng karon. Kung tinuod ta ang ligasan ng nagahinong masa Ginoo, Saint Paul, sa ating ganuhang pagbasa, maisugo niyo ni Sakyaw ang Ebanghelyo sa Ginoo, isang kahibalo siya, na i-disown siya sa iyang family, kay siya usaman ka pariseo. Kay balo siya, gawas ay disown, pamilyan po siya sa iyahang katugong ng mga Hudeyo. Tungod sa iyang pagsangyaw sa Ebanghelyo ni Kristo. Pero, kahibalo siya si Paul, unsay kapalit sa iyahang ihatag na pagsangyaw sa Ginoo. Kay bawag si San Pablo nga bisan paman mawala sa iya ang tanan pero nagpapiling siya ni Kristo nga sa una iya ang ipatay karon mao'y na iya isangyaw ang Ebanghelyo ni Kristo. Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, give to God what belongs to God. Sa atong panahon karon bisod ka ayong maghatag o kanang panahon pa or time to pause for a moment, for a while. Muhunong sa mga Diyos o kanagaling maghampo sa Diyos pinaagi sa ilong. Kanagaling maghatag o personal time sa ilong. Sa karon na panahon, bisod ka ayong pagsulti sa Ginoo. Gawas pag-attend sa Santos na Misa, kanagaling naakay ihatag na panahon sa Diyos sa iyong kaugaling oras. Tinigmata ang unang pagitaon ng cellphone. Kuting yung cellphone, morning babe, wala kayo na good morning sa Ginoo, good morning na kayo na kayo. No? Kasi ko, karoon na panahon, isa ka ayong mga isoon. Pusa, itang mga minuyagan, you should make a stand. You should make a difference. Kita niyong magpakita sa gahong ni Kristo ng Misa, kanilita. Kita niyong bahala mag-inusara ang katahanan, bili, o wala nagatuon o nasayon kinsa si Kristo sa ilang hinabuhi, munang wala sila nagsunod sa hinabuhi Kristo ano? Kita, ng mga nangyayagan, may stand. Kinahanan kahibaw ka kinsa si Kristo sa iyong hinabuhi. Ngayon kahibaw ka kinsa si Kristo sa iyong hinabuhi, dili ka maulang mamurus before ka sa kayong jay. Before ka masagay ng ito, di ka maulang mamurus at tumahan sa simbahan. Kaya kahit pa lang Kristal si Kristo sa inyong kinabuhi every time you made the sign of the cross. And that's very powerful. Importante kayo mga eksoon mo na natanan dito kung nakailado mo ni Kristo sa inyong pagsasagsak ang mga kinabuhi. At kung nakaila mo, inyong din ang pagkapunyan. Kaya hindi mo gusto manawala ka ng Kristo sa inyong kinabuhi. Inyong din nakatagal ng panahon, hindi mo gusto mawala ka na si Kristo sa inyong kinabuhi. Murag mo yan ba? Inyong din nakatagal ng kinang time ang magpabili ang relasyon. Murag ba na ang asawa? Kinahanglan din ang time sa usan-usan para magpabili ang relasyon. Ingon anak mo ka nato si Kristo mga eksoon. Atong buhaton ang tanan para dili mawala si Kristo sa atong kinabuhi. Atong panalimdan, atong hatagan ng panahon, especially sa atong personal time. Atong ginaong kinabuhi time sa Ginoo. Ato ginagawa si Kristo panahon para mga isuon mas ato siyang mahilhan, ato siyang mahigugma, ato siyang mas duon sa atong kasing-kasing. Ang mga Pariseo, ang mga Herodians, wala silang kailangan kumikisan si Kristo. Mauna, dimiss big time. Kaya until now, they are still waiting for the Messiah to come. Wala sila kadawat sa bagong kasulatan, New Testament, na maungalan si Kristo. Kita, atong gidawat, pinaagi sa punya, atong gidawat si Kristo sa atong kasasaksa sa mga kinabuhi. Atong ginagampingan, atong ginagatagan o panahon, atong ginagumakon para dili mawala si Kristo sa atong kinabuhi. Inawat mga isuon, sa atong pagkagaya ni Santos yung isa, sa atong pagdawat sa lawas ni Kristo, atong mas mahilihan ang Diyos na nagpakatao, nagpakamatay, tungod ka na ako. Ako siyang gawaton, ako siyang nagpumamon sa kong kaugalingong kinabuhi. Pinaagi sa pagbuhan, sa pangayo, paglikay, sa mga Diyong maayon, pinaagi sa paghatag. Pagbunsay angay sa Diyos, pinaagi sa paghatag. Pagbunsay angay, kung alam sa Ginoo, pinaagi pa sa paglikay sa mga diling angay sa Ginoo. Amen. Please all stand and together with us for us. I believe in God.
Of all things visible and invisible, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Today, we are reminded of our duty to fulfill our civic and religious obligations As we pray for the grace to harmonize both, let us remember in a special manner those who find it difficult to do so. Let our response be, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the universal church, may we enjoy freedom of action in proclaiming and promoting the gospel values in all civil societies. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the Holy Father, our bishop, our parish priest, and other religious leaders, may they evermore successfully enlighten us on how best to fulfill our civic and religious duties. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our government officials and all other civil leaders, may they lead us by their honesty and integrity in fulfilling their obligations to God and country. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our missionaries throughout the world, may the Lord make their apostolate fruitful, give them strength to overcome all difficulties, and reward their generosity with everlasting life. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our community, may all of us always fulfill our duties as honest citizens and good Catholics, and thereby contribute to the building of God's kingdom on earth. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray in silence for our personal intentions. Let us pray.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord God, we thank you for having made us citizens of our country and members of your church. Grant us an ever better appreciation of this true gift and an ever greater eagerness to contribute to the good of both through the exemplary fulfillment of our civic and religious duties. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, in sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be blessed by the very mysteries to serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cost of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. By the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they become for us the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. At whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving it thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving it thanks. And gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." So that I may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, with Saint Augustine and Monica, in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. We deserve advances of our Pope, Jose Palma, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen richly to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you after passing from this life, especially those we include in the intention of this whole sacrifice for us. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. In our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may always free from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of a loving Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Away. Behold you partake of the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to partake to the banquet of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.